Well, I know Amir. He's an old friend of my sister's, and I saw this film a few months ago, just when he was trying to get it out to the broader public. I've seen it three times now, so this is my fourth. But it's the most sensational piece of work, and it just shows what people power can do. I think what we've found in the last few years is that we feel slightly disconnected from the system, disconnected from any form of power. And all of those of us who were on the march back in February, well, gosh, it was 2003 now, wasn't it? Finally, it's playing itself out. And the million, 2 million of us, however many it was, I think we did start to create some sort of change. And hopefully we can keep that change going. And films like Amir's film, which is extraordinary, will hopefully galvanize people into more action, more moments on the street, more moments of civil disobedience, perhaps. Wouldn't that be fun? I think one of the things that's been made clear to us over the years, and it's possibly not a new thing, but the fact that the people in power do lie. And if they don't lie, then they're disingenuous and they don't tell the truth. And I think we found very clearly, especially with the dodgy dossier and the 45 minutes of leasing chemical weapons on the rest of us, that was just pure fabrication. And the difficulty is that the chattering classes such as myself had problems with it, but we were told very dogmatically from the powers that be, from Tony Blair and his lot, that it was absolute truth, God's honest truth, and was enough to lead us into a war situation which nobody wanted. This is the real thrust of the argument. And then spool forward to 10 or so years later, we have a similar claim about Syria. People go back onto the streets, and for the first time in 231 years, a sitting government loses a vote on going to war. Now, that's not bad, is it? Well, unfortunately, he's not with us anymore, but God bless him, old Tony Benn, who appears throughout the film, but especially at the end of the film, and he's there after the successful Syria march when the government lost their motion. And he said, look, it's taken me 50 years. It doesn't matter if you only win once in 50 years. It's a win. We have to just keep pushing. We have to keep asking the questions. We have to keep going on the streets. We have to keep making our elected politicians be open and honest and frank with us. And that's the only power we have. I've got a piece of work that I think is coming out in July on the BBC called The Outcast. So we have a screening of it at the BFI in a couple of weeks' time. And apart from that, I don't know.
Can you tell us just quickly anything about that, The Outcast, where you fit into that, what it's about?
The Outcast is a wonderful novel written by Sadie Jones. It won the Costa Prize a few years ago. And it's been adapted by Sadie into a 2 90-minute part set between 1945 and late 50s. It's quite dysfunctional, quite dark, quite bleak, but really wonderful piece of writing and some fantastic performances. I saw the cast and crew screening of it a couple of weeks ago, and I'm very proud to be in it. And it even reduced me to tears, and I know what happens in it. So it's a very powerful piece of writing.